Today we are going to try some tricks on how to change this waterfall landscape to a moody looking one with the free Snapseed app. First, I'm going to do some basic edits in the tune image, increasing the shadows for details in the darker parts and little decrease in the highlights. Adding contrast. Also a lot of saturation for the greens to pop. Now to make the image more interesting, I'm gonna pop few brighter parts. To do that, make the image a lot darker by reducing the brightness. Then with masking, tap the stacks icon, view edits, the last tune image edit and brush. Here with the effect enabled and the brush value at 0, I'm gonna tap on some bright parts to remove the dark effect and make the image pop. Tap the eye icon for a visual cue on where the masking is applied or removed. Next, using the curves tool, I'm going to brighten the midtones and the highlights. Waterfalls looks overexposed, so going to the masking and removing the effect on the waterfalls. Now for some dodge and burning with the brush tool to give further pop to the landscape. With the value at 5, brushing on the bright parts to make them brighter. The more you brush, the more brighter it becomes. Now with the value at -5, darkening the darker parts further. Next, I'm gonna try to add some haze. With the curves, moving the bottom point upper, which lifts the blacks towards white. I'll stop right around here. Then with masking, tapping on the parts where the haze effect need to be applied. Around the base of the waterfalls. Also around the top for a hazy look. Next, we'll try to add some color to the sky. With the red curve, I'm gonna move the top point towards left, which basically adds red to the brightest part, that is the sky here, also the waterfalls. Also moving the middle part back so that it affects only the sky. and now adding yellow in a similar way by moving the blue curve towards right. Note that moving the blue curve left adds blue, but to the right adds the opposite color yellow. With masking, removing the effect on the waterfalls and a bit around. Now for some selective edits with the selective filters. To make the sky a little more interesting, adding a selective filter around here to darken that part a bit. Also one towards the right to brighten that part. One on these rocks where I'm gonna add more structure. So here are the changes after each edit made. And the final output. Thanks for watching.